So my name is Logan Engstrom, and I'm a computer science major at MIT, and I'm going to talk about the trade-offs associated with robust machine learning. So in machine learning recently, there's been an explosion in the use of neural networks to do image tasks, and neural networks have absolutely blown away the competition on a bunch of standard image classification tasks. But they all suffer from the same vulnerability of adversarial examples. Adversarial examples are examples where you take an input and then you perturb it very slightly. And to a human, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between this original input and the perturbed input. But to the classifier, you totally fool it. So for example, you can take a picture of this pig. You can add a little bit of perturbation that looks like noise to a human, and that you can't even tell the difference between this image and that image, actually. And it turns out that this image with the added noise classifies as an airplane instead of a pig. So this is a really big problem. It's prevalent throughout all state-of-the-art image classification models, and there's been a huge line of work on trying to fix this problem. And it turns out that the most successful methods for fixing this problem, for making networks that are more robust, also caused classifiers to have a significantly lower accuracy than just training naturally and making a model that has high accuracy but is not very robust. So what we set out to do is try to figure out if there's really a fundamental trade-off here or if we're just not doing things correctly. So we start out with a theoretical model. In our theoretical model, we essentially show that there does exist a setting where there's a fundamental trade-off between accuracy and robustness. And it's a pretty natural model. And this statement is essentially of the form that if you reach a certain amount of accuracy, you have to have at most this amount of robust accuracy, and vice versa. Now, we have this hypothesis. We now move on to actually verifying it in the real world, using classifiers that are actually used in the real world on real world data sets. We completed a bunch of experiments that verified our hypothesis. We showed that in the large sample regime, if you try to make classifiers are significantly more robust than the naturally trained classifiers, then there is a fundamental trade-off here, at least in the classifiers that we have today. But in the small sample regime, you can actually see that the making classifiers more robust actually helps, and it essentially acts as a form of data augmentation to make your classifiers even more accurate. But in the large sample regime, we see the same predicted phenomenon that we saw in our theoretical model. And the large sample regime is what we really care about in the real world. Now, we have these problems with training these robust classifiers, but are they really problems? And is there kind of a silver lining here? And so it turns out that these robust classifiers are actually more aligned with human vision in terms of how they classify images. And this makes sense because you can essentially think of robust classifiers as being more invariant around in a very small L2 norm ball around every single example. And in human terms, that's basically like you have some kind of image, and then if you add a very small perturbation to it that a human couldn't tell the difference between, then the human's not gonna be able to tell the difference, like kind of tautologically. And so if we make it so that these classifiers are more robust just around the example, then that means that they're gonna be more human, they're gonna be more aligned with the way the human vision works. And we can actually see this when trying to interpret the way that these classifiers make decisions. So you can see here, this is a beetle, or an insect, and we're trying to classify it as an insect or a dog or a cat or one of any other labels. And so in this, with a standard classifier that's been trained without trying to make the classifier robust, the heat map of what the classifier cares about basically looks like noise. And so you can kind of see that there's like a vague outline of a beetle, but if you were to see this a priori, you would have no idea why this classifier was making this decision. But it turns out that when you add this robustness guarantee, the gradients become much more aligned. That is, the parts of the image that the classifier cares about become significantly more aligned with what humans actually care about. And so you can see here in this gradient, in this heat map of what the classifier cares about, you can see that there's essentially an outline of the beetle. And you can see why this classifier made this decision. This is the original example that we're trying to classify. This is the heat map of what the standard classifier cares about. This right here is the heat map of what the adversarially trained robust classifier cares about. And you can see it's much more aligned. We have these experiments about showing what happens when you have large norm adversarial examples. So this is basically saying, what happens if the classifier, what happens if we can make adversarial examples that that can be as far away as we want from the classifier. And so from the original input. So instead of making it so that the adversarial examples have to be imperceptible from the original image, we're going to make it so they can be as big as they want. It turns out that when you make a large norm adversarial example starting from this guy with a standard classifier, you basically get the same monkey. But when you try to make the same adversarial example starting from this guy going to the L2 trained adversarial example, you actually get something that looks like a dog. Showing that these classifiers, to really fool them, you actually have to make images that look like the adversarial class that you're trying to fool them with.